In this video, I'm going to be showing you exactly how to set up and use SkyAlyn to align your Nexstar telescope. In other words, this is the sky alignment process that you need to do before you can begin using your telescope. Now, as you can see in front of me, here is the Celestron Nexstar 127 SLT, and that's what I'm going to be using to showcase these process steps and for the demo. But bear in mind that you can follow this process for any Celestron computerized telescope in the Nexstar series. So if you've got the 4SE, 6SE, 8SE, the process remains the same. So a quick note before we begin with the sky alignment procedure. The reason why we're doing this is it enables the telescope to accurately point to objects in the sky. So we first need to align it with known positions or stars in the sky. With this information, the telescope can create a model of the sky, which it uses to locate any object in the database. So just bear that in mind as we run through these next steps. So the first thing that you're going to need to do is remove this cap here. There are handles on each side. I just did that ahead of recording, that's why it's a little bit loose. And you need to input the batteries. So for the 127 SLT and for this telescope, I need 8 AA batteries. So there's 4 in each one of those. Basically, I'll put those in there, and then I'll basically put the lid back on. So here are my batteries, I need to put those in. I'll show you what they look like when they're done in a second. Put those in, and then I'm just gonna put that back on like that. The batteries are now in. I've put those in the correct position so that the wires aren't going to get caught. And now I'm just going to put this cap over the top and secure this all in place. You next want to locate the switch to turn the telescope on. So I've now just done that. And you'll notice, assuming your batteries are incorrectly, this will turn on as well. So now I just need to select my language. So I need to put this in as 0, enter to accept, and here we go. At this screen, we can move to the next step. Now, just looking at this hand control, you will notice that there are directional arrows in the center. Now, these only move the telescope. They cannot be used to scroll through the menu features. So these are the arrows that I'm referring to. Now we need to align the finderscope. So the first thing we need to do is to turn it on. So it's this little cog here. Hopefully you heard that click. I'm turning that on and I'm moving it the whole way. At this point, you want to return to the hand control panel and you want to use these buttons here to essentially move the telescope. So hopefully you can hear and see that moving. And what we want to do is we want to identify and locate an object in the distance. So obviously this depends if you're doing it in the day, like I am, or if you're doing it at night. So if you're doing it at night, you can use an object like the moon. But for me and for this demo, I'm gonna be using a chimney. There's a chimney up here. I don't know if you can see it through the trees. I'm gonna be trying to locate that. Now, what I need to do is essentially move the telescope to lock onto that chimney. And just be mindful, I do need to remove my caps because we will be looking through the eyepiece in order to basically ensure that we can see it through the eyepiece. So I need to remove this lens cap as well. In order to accurately center an object in the eyepiece, you may need to change the motor speed. So to do that, there's a button in the bottom right-hand corner of the hand control panel. It's called motor speed. On some of these kind of older panels, it may be called something else. I think it's called it might be a rate button. But anyway, you need to click that and you basically need to change. So it'll go from 1 to 9, 9 being fastest, 1 being slowest. So make sure you've set that. When you're happy, hit enter. With the object centered when looking down into the eyepiece, you then want to use the azimuth, the right, left, and altitude up down adjustment knobs on the finderscope to place the red alignment dot directly over the centered object. So here are the different knobs that you need to manipulate at this particular point. Once you have aligned your finderscope, make sure you turn it off to conserve its battery. Now you are ready to align the telescope. Now note, this will have to be done at night. but I am going to be showing you the process continuing in this video in the day, just to show you exactly what you will need to do. It'll be easier for me to record and for you to see it all, but bear in mind the next steps, you should do this at night. So now imagine it is nighttime and it's all dark around us. The first thing you're going to need to do is turn your telescope back on if you did turn it off. Now I do recommend doing that to conserve battery. Now we want to head over to our hand control panel and we need to basically set all of this up. So you should see that it reads next star at the top when you are ready to move on to the next step. So press enter. Now you want to select the sky align option. It should be the first one listed. If it's not, then you can use the buttons 9 and 6 to go up and down. We're going to be using these quite a lot. Now, don't make the mistake. These buttons move the telescope and not these menu options. It's these buttons you need to use. So we want skyline. Now we need to choose from the city database. We basically want to find a location nearest to us. So obviously that will depend on your own needs, but at this point, just select the city database and press enter. Select your continent. So again, if you need to change that, press 9 to go down. And you're basically just scrolling with these buttons. So Europe is where I'm based, so press enter on that. Select your country, again scroll down the country options until you get to your one where you're located. I'm United Kingdom. And then you need to select your city. So I'm going to use this button here to find my nearest location. Hopefully you can see that. London is my nearest location, so press enter when you're happy with that. You then want to enter your current time. So for the purpose of this demo, I'm going to say it's 10 at night. So you can see here it's hours, minutes, seconds. So I'm going to put 1000000, enter. And now you need to select whether it's the AM or PM. So this is PM, because it's at night, remember, press enter. Press enter for standard time. Now you need to select or put in your date information. So let's just say it's April, so 04, and it's the 24th today, and it's year 24. So you put that information in. If you do any of this wrong or want to go back, press the back button. Okay, now press enter. And we have now set up the hand control panel. You now want to use the directional arrow keys on the hand control to move the telescope towards any bright celestial object in the sky. Now, the moon works particularly well for this. So remember, we're using these buttons here, just moving this telescope. Let's just assume the moon is overhead. Move it, you know, to the moon. The moon works particularly well, but you can use any other bright object in the sky, but that is usually the largest. Now at this point, you want to center the object in the finder scope. So in our finder scope here, center it, turn this on, look through here, center it, and then you want to press enter on this panel. If the finder scope has been properly aligned, the alignment star should now be visible in the field of view of the eyepiece. So in other words, when you look through the eyepiece, in here you should be able to see the alignment star, such as the moon. Return back to the hand control and it will prompt you to center the bright alignment star in the center of the eyepiece. Once you have that centered, press the align button, which you can see top left. This will accept the star as your first alignment position. So I'm now going to press that. It will say center object one at this particular moment. It will now read center object 2. Now for the second alignment object, choose a bright star or planet as far from the first alignment object as possible. So if you chose the moon for the first object, you basically want to go far from that object. Once again, use the directional arrow buttons to center the object in the finder scope and press enter. Once the object is centered in the eyepiece, press the align button again. So let's just say we move the telescope, move it onto a different object. We're moving quite far away. We're happy with that. Enter and then align. You then need to repeat the process for the third alignment star. When the telescope has been aligned to the final star, the display will read match confirmed. Now that your telescope is properly aligned, you are ready to find your first object. So if you are working from one of the newer models, you will have buttons such as solar system, stars, deep sky, and you can select any one of these buttons and then you basically just choose the object that you want to observe. Now these are objects that are visible at the date and location entered. If you've got the older model, the older Nexstar hand control, you may need to press the Tor button, which you'll find on the controller. If you want further information about a particular object, then you can press the Object Info button. You now should have aligned your Celestron Nexstar telescope. I hope this video has been useful. Any questions, comments, feedback, drop them down below. Best of luck with your observations, and I really hope you enjoy using your Nexstar telescope.